it's the 25th anniversary of the ThinkPad. To mark the occasion, Lenovo commissioned a history of the first ever and the best-selling laptop in history. The book, How the ThinkPad Changed the World and is Shaping the Future, gives us the remarkable history of the man who invented the laptop and his creation. William J. Holstein met with ThinkPad's creator, Erimasa Naito. At the time, Naito was working for Yamato Labs in Japan under IBM.
Well, Naito was just unstoppable. He would get off a flight from the United States back to Japan and go straight to the laboratory to try to solve a problem. He would stay up all night for weeks on end.
As Holstein writes in his book, How the ThinkPad Changed the World, the ThinkPad has been to the top of Mount Everest and the depths of the ocean. Scientists used it to study the biodiversity of the canopies of rainforests. The ThinkPad went on the first exhibition to travel the entire length of the Blue Nile and the Nile River. NASA enthusiastically embraced the machine, and it has served on both the International Space Station and the Mir Space Station. Because of one of its designs, the butterfly, the ThinkPad is even part of the permanent collection at the Museum of Modern Art in New York.
The ThinkPad is positioned in that ecosystem as the one device that is for serious users. If you want to exchange digital designs, or if you want documents or spreadsheets, serious content, it needs to be on something like a ThinkPad.
In the book, Holstein tells the inside story of how ThinkPad came into being and how people responded to it. Project Nectarine gave ThinkPad a color screen. The torture chamber was created to test ThinkPad in a real-world environment so that it could withstand the abuse a typical teenager would put it through. ThinkPad Yoga appeared around 2013, the first laptop that was hinged so it could be folded backward with the screen facing out. Plus, Yoga incorporated a screen that could be written on with a special pen for seamless collaboration.
President George Bush I knew John Akers, who was the chairman of CEO of IBM. The president didn't introduce himself or didn't say, "Hi, I'm George Bush." He just started saying, I want a ThinkPad." And they put one on the next plane up and delivered it to the White House. And so it was after that that George Bush sent a check and a thank you card to Jim Steele for getting it done so easily and so quickly.
Most important, Holstein describes ThinkPad's impact. More than 100 million ThinkPads have been sold since its introduction.
You could carry this computer, so suddenly the true power of mobile computing was revealed.
ThinkPad was revolutionary 25 years ago and remains revolutionary today. It is the black box that goes anywhere, the computer that changed the world. We'll be right back.